area, people waiting.
Yep.
First.
Hello, everybody. We're back with part two of the live stream. This is Kevin, tattoo artist, and we are almost done with the tattoo. So if you weren't here in the live stream before, we were just starting. We streamed for about 2 hours. Yeah, so we got about a half hour left. He's gonna put on some detail work. But yeah, it looks so awesome.
Oh yeah, why is it over our...
Hi everybody.
Ready?
Yep.
I'm gonna watch, I can talk.
Hi Chase.
Watch it.
Why does it have a face over the mask?
I don't know.
How many people are in the room right now?
Never know.
There's 108 people watching right now.
I was gonna say, right when you turn it on is when it's like
booming.
Ooh. Touch my face.
Oh, it changes? What's wrong with the other hand?
I see a lot of people saying hi, but it's really hard to read your usernames, but hi everybody.
Hola.
Someone asked, what's on the TV? What's playing?
I forgot. I don't know.
Some 80s group.
No, on the TV.
The TV.
Oh, the
There's
TV.
Is it a commercial?
No, that's a movie.
Oh.
I can't remember what it's called. Hey, Steve, what's this movie called? You know?
New Country for Old Men?
New Country
for Old Men. Yeah, no Country for Old Men.
No
country. New Country. Put the old men in the new country. We don't need them here.
I'll put some old people somewhere.
Send them away.
I see a lot of people asking, does it hurt? Yes, it hurts. It actually hurts really badly. But my face does not show it.
Yes, it does.
Well, right now, I'm like staring dead at the camera. Why are you getting this tattoo? Does it have a special reason or meaning behind it? It's Aslan the Lion from Narnia. I'm obsessed with the whole Narnia series, especially The Lion, the Witch, and the Wardrobe. And lions are my favorite animal, so why not really combine the two? What was the movie that was called on Play's Plane?
New Country for Old Men?
New
no
country,
country
for
Old No Country for Old Men.
No Country for Old Men.
It's a tongue twister.
Okay. Something about Old Men.
Something with old men.
I think it's like it won like a lot of awards. I think it's the Amazon movie, right?
I think it's won a lot of awards, like an Oscar.
Oh, that's an award.
One,
yeah, no
a lot of awards. One Oscar.
Oh, that's a good movie.
I think I tried watching it and I hate it.
So I see a question, where Megan's tattoo done? We're at Stay True Tattoo on Menor Avenue. I love how that rhymes.
Stay True Tattoo.
Someone asked, what's my first tattoo? I can't show it to you right now because it is on the same arm that I'm getting tattooed, but it is, it's Nevermore, right here. Little thingy. I got it about 4 years ago. I can't tell if that's ink or blood.
It's a mix.
It's a mix.
It's a bloody mix.
Ew.
It's all over my gloves.
I see a lot of comments popping up, but I'm having a really hard time reading them.
Why?
Because it's really small print, my vision's really bad.
Well, want me to turn it and we could read them?
You could.
No one wants to look at us.
You'll see.
Turn it around.
Alright, so this is the folks behind the camera for a second. My name's John, I'm the boyfriend, and you're...
I'm Kelly, I'm her friend.
She's the friend. We can read this,
yes. We can read it.
Can you see that right?
I can see it.
Adjust the camera.
Alright. Oh, you're taking it like a champ. No, the tattoo doesn't hurt us at all. We feel pretty good.
I'm good.
Oh, I'm sorry. All right. Well,
they say hi.
I'm gonna have to tilt it up.
Jason Edwards is John. What up, my dude?
What's up, dude?
Hi, John and Kelly. Hey.
All right. So yeah, you see Danny's right there. Did you ever think you'd have so many tattoos? I'll let you do the talking.
You can do the talking.
Was that a question?
Yeah.
No, actually, I did not. I didn't really get into tattoos until about 5 years ago, and then I got my first one 4 years ago. And like people always say, tattoos are addictive, and it's like you get one and like you can't just stop at one.
Someone asked, what would you suggest for a starter tattoo?
Probably like a word or a quote or something. Something simple. This is really hurting.
Stroke your beard, please. Get on it. I'm just kidding.
Someone says, what is your most meaningful tattoo?
Most meaningful tattoo would probably have to be the rose. Because...
Wow.
Because this part right here... you see that?
I know, they're crazy.
All the swirls.
There's so many.
This represents like my negative thinking, my depression, and so everything just kind of spiraling out of control. But at the same time, it blooms into who I am today. So
anyone you want.
You go.
I have a good one.
It's so cute.
You can make them come back.
Yeah. There's one. There's a comment I saw. Kind of like, oh, would you ever do a trailer on Game Theory or Doctor Who?
I have done a trailer of MatPat from Game Theory. If you check out the Nightmare Theory, I'm not sure if I'll do one just on him because he doesn't really put out videos of him besides his live streams, and that's just him playing video games. So it's really hard. It'll be really hard to use just that footage. And I'm not gonna do TV shows at least for a long while. Because there's way too much footage to go through that. There's like hundreds of episodes.
It has to be a show you're kind of familiar with, yeah, I think, like so you know where to look.
If I were to do a trailer on a TV show, it would be American Horror Story, iCarly, Victorious, SpongeBob.
Better get on that Stranger Things trailer.
I can't download Netflix series.
We'll bootleg it. Hold on, what did it say? You look good, I would potentially ask you for a date, but I hate girls with tattoos.
Bitch, I have a boyfriend!
Oh! Oh, Lord.
My fingers hanging
out. Did I scare you?
No.
She turned it around real quick. Can you do another Dan and Phil trailer? By the way, love ya.
Oh, I love you too. I'm trying to focus on talking because this is really bad.
You got this.
Maybe I'm not entirely sure because everyone knows this, but they only put out like 3 videos a year. That's kind of an exaggeration. They do put out a few videos a year. They're very sporadic. But really, like horror is like the main thing I could twist it into.
Maybe a comedy,
but I'm not sure.
Answer a question?
I feel like I should raise my hand to ask a question. There's some people asking, are you going to do a trailer, or can you do a trailer on Coraline? It seems very popular.
I've seen a ton of comments for that.
It's a movie
and
with the girl with the button.
I've seen a ton of comments for Coraline, and I will be putting it on my list very soon. I'm not sure if I'll do 7 different genres.
Is it like a new movie? Or?
No.
It came out like 8 years ago, maybe?
Okay. I was sleeping.
Oh, you were sleeping?
Maybe like 7-8 years ago. It's a good movie. It's stop motion animation. I don't know if I'll be doing 7 different genres on it. Just because it's so purely horror, it might be hard to do 7 different genres.
It's funny, I kind of know the answer to a lot of these.
John
could
just answer.
Yeah, I know. What trailer took the longest to make? Well, go on.
The trailer that took the longest to make was Unsubscribed, unsurprisingly. It took almost a month to make, doing all those visual effects. I am not skilled in visual effects at all. Just video editing. That took a long, long, long time to make. It's coming up on a year since that came out, on the 29th.
Can you do a horror Panic at the Disco trailer? You just did!
I just did! Guys, pro tip. Before you suggest any trailers that you think I may have done already, just please do your research and just look at the playlist of all trailers, please. It'll take like 5 minutes. Like you don't have to watch all of them, just scroll through. Like, it's not that hard, please.
Who do you like best? Mark, Jack, or Felix?
Oh boy.
Putting you on the spot here.
Well, I just saw Markiplier live 2 weeks ago, or like a week and a half ago. So I hold Mark near and dear to my heart. Jack, I really like a lot because I just did a trailer on him. He's just a cute little green bean. And then Felix, he's very, very sporadic, but I mean, I like all three of them. I don't really want to put one above the other. But if I were to pick two out of the three, it would be Mark and Jack. No offense to Felix. I also really like him, but I prefer.
I'm a John Barter fan.
I guess. Prefer Mark and Jack.
I'll take it.
Somebody said they're a fan of you.
Yeah.
Oh yeah. Me too.
Oh wow.
John Barta is from Sparta. This is Sparta!
Hey, did you know that John has his own YouTube channel? If you go, just search John Barta, and it'll be coming up his... Is it John Barta or This Is Barta?
This Is Barta.
Yeah. I think it's Barta.
Either John Barta or This Is Barta. B-A-R-T-A.
That's pretty cool.
I made two videos, okay? It's not quite a channel.
Show him some love.
What the hell are you doing?
How are you sliding away?
Show him some love and tell him that he needs to make more videos.
Alright,
subscribe to This Is Barta.
You probably answered this earlier. Someone a long time ago asked, what is the next tattoo that you're planning on getting and how many tattoos do you want?
I could burp. Sorry. Ooh. Oh, that was a watery one.
Your favorite
one.
That was good.
The next tattoo that I want will probably be on the back of my right shoulder. It'll be an elephant with a cardinal in watercolor.
Oh.
And if you're wondering why, it's a memory of my grandparents. It passed away about 10 years ago. The elephant represents my grandpa because he would always tell this one elephant joke. And then the cardinal represents my grandma because she loved bird watching and her favorite bird was the cardinal. And I don't really have a number limit on my... What are you doing?
Laughing at the comments.
Okay. I don't really have a number limit of how many tattoos that I want or I'm gonna get. Like, if I want one, I'm gonna get one. Who's to tell me I'll be stopping?
The one you like from the comments that you saw you wanted to ask? No, not that one. We're not asking that one.
What was that?
Yeah, we talked about that one after the thing. But some of you guys are very naughty in the chat room.
People talking smack.
What was the joke? The elephant joke that your grandpa told?
So the joke goes, what did Tarzan say when he saw elephants walking down the road? I told you guys, but you
can't tell me. What did he say?
He said, oh look, there are elephants going down the road. Now what did Tarzan say when he saw elephants walking down the road with sunglasses on?
I do.
Nothing. He didn't recognize them. No, that's the joke.
They want to know if I have any tattoos.
You, Kelly? Here. Flip the camera around.
I think they're talking about me. I do have tattoos. I have that tattoo, this tattoo. How do I do this?
This tattoo
and another tattoo on my hip.
Nothing.
Nope. He's blank.
Backwards.
I'm back.
My leg. Oh, your eyes.
Oh, what was the punchline? Someone's connection quit right before the punchline.
I'll just retell the joke.
I'm still trying to figure out the joke. You told me about
really
it 20
it.
Times.
No. What did Tarzan say when he saw elephants walking down the road? Hey look, there are elephants walking down the road. Now what did Tarzan say when he saw elephants walking down the road with sunglasses on? Nothing. He didn't recognize them. That's the joke. Grandpa humor.
Grandpa jokes. All day.
Am My grandpa was very proud of the joke.
I would be.
it would always make us laugh when we were little.
So this is kind of topical. Favorite film?
The Chronicles of Narnia, The Lion, The Witch, and the Wardrobe. Hence why I'm getting the Aslan tattoo. And it hurts a lot.
Someone says, what are your opinions on Nate Wants to Battle's music? Please answer.
Do you know the piece of the username?
Me?
Yeah, do you see the username of that person?
Oh, Lakin Mercer.
Lakin Mercer? I really like Nate Wants to Battle's music. I really like how he sounds like Brendan Urie, because his Panic at the Disco covers are incredible.
I love the Beatles. Sorry, someone asked if you like the Beatles.
I don't.
Well, someone actually asked, what music does the folks in the room like? So, you can answer first.
Oh.
I like pop. I almost said pulp.
Pulp. I like pulp in my orange juice.
Pop. alternative. Indie pop. I like hip hop.
Now I know what it's like for him. Hard to keep up.
I really like movie soundtracks a lot, like instrumentals and orchestra. How about you?
I really like anything. Mm-hmm. Like a lot of reggae, like a lot of alternative.
But country?
Not a big fan of country.
Anything but country.
Neither.
I mean, my mom listened to country a little bit growing up, and I just kind of got used to it, you know? Not really ever, I don't have anything against it. I appreciate music for what it is, so I can't say that I don't like it, but...
Yeah.
Not my thing.
Where you sit music wise?
Why, my face is covered. What are we used to?
Music do you like?
Oh, music do I like?
Yeah.
Well, my favorite band's Brand New.
You heard the new record, right?
The one that just came out?
Yeah. It's actually really good. I haven't
really
heard
good.
Any of the previous stuff of theirs, but I really like that record.
Me too. Wait, you haven't heard any?
I mean, maybe.
I can't read from back here.
I don't listen to 21 Pilots, but I don't know. I like a lot of things. They're some of my favorite artists. I like Kanye West a lot. David Bowie, Radiohead.
You like, what's that guy's name?
Kendrick Lamar.
Yeah, Kendrick Lamar, Frank Ocean. Of older groups, the Beatles are great. Black Sabbath.
Opeth.
You know. Opeth, yeah, for my progressive metal fans. I want to get more into Bob Dylan. Someone mentioned Bob Dylan. I heard a Highway 61 Revisited, and I think it's okay, but I'm not ready for Bob Dylan right now.
I have to get, like, really close to this.
Why?
I don't want to, like, lay like this in the video.
We might have missed something as they were talking.
Did we?
I mean, I'm sure they said a bunch, but...
Question. Oh. Do you have any YouTubers that you haven't made a video for that you plan to make in the future?
Yes, I do. Olan Rogers has been on the list for a while. I've been, like, on and off with Logan Paul. Probably not gonna do one for him because the Paul brothers are just kind of like they're not really that great of people, so I don't want to feed into the fire of that and like really give them any more attention than they need. First of all, Britannic, I plan on making videos for them. I want to do one on Key and Peele. So I'll have to find videos from them on YouTube. This is very painful. Yeah, for all of you guys who do not have tattoos but also but want one, yes, they do hurt.
We're going
somebody
on, like,
says,
four and a half hours.
Endure the pain, Danny.
Oh, I'm enduring.
Endure.
Oh. Someone said they never thought you would be a girl.
Me neither.
Man.
Last time I checked, I'm still a girl. That looks so cool.
Bring him up.
I'm not.
My arm is so dead right now.
Would you ever start vlogging or make a personal channel? Well, yeah, when are we getting the John and Danny YouTube channel?
I don't know. Maybe when we move in together, we'll have...
I was going to say, all the videos would just be of her editing and me listening to music. That's the extent of the video.
A little more to go.
Just a little bit more. What do you guys think so far?
I think it's good.
Oh, this is fantastic. Oh, my arm's going to fall off.
Whoa, what's happening?
Oh, the chat is delayed by 15 seconds.
Well, everyone just commented at once.
Would you remove someone that's saying annoying things?
What? Would I remove?
Yeah, from the chat. Mm-hmm. Should I press remove or blah?
What would they say?
Stuff.
Mm-hmm. What kind of stuff? Like offensive stuff?
Yeah.
Delete it. Yeah, block.
Block?
Yeah.
Sure, not remove, block.
Well, remove for now, and if they come back and say it again, then block them.
Hello.
Wesley!
Oh,
hi.
What's up?
Welcome to the stream!
The live stream.
How's it going?
Did you really?
You smell like a sandwich.
Wesley's here.
He's a mess.
You're a mess.
These two folks just got married over the weekend. Look at that!
You really smell like a sandwich.
He does.
I do! I can smell
my gosh!
Someone says, hey Wes. That's you. What? Say hi.
Hello.
I don't know, the guy's still there. Whatever.
It's a gun.
Yeah, what is that person saying?
I don't want to give him attention.
Okay, then block it. Is it just continue? Is it, does his new name start with an H?
What's your favorite color?
Favorite color is rose gold.
Green.
You guys.
What's so how did the sandwich fall?
Oh. My favorite color is turquoise.
It's a good color. Like, it's the color of my
like. Oh shoot, I just like scratched myself in the face. Oh! Ow.
Not funny.
You're just like the person that fainted and laughed at them. This is not right.
The camera should be pointed at you guys.
I know, I'm probably bleeding, right? I'm bleeding more than you are. What is so funny?
Busted.
John just poked himself in the eye.
Oh, what happened to me?
I'm sorry, I'm
bad. Oh, my back.
Your back's
hurting? A little bit.
Leslie's favorite color is purple.
Hey, I'm gonna choose a few Yeah, dude. I know. Whatever you want, man.
So, if you guys are just joining us, I'm getting my 10th tattoo with Kevin Cly right here. And we are at Say True Tattoo on Manor Avenue. If you want to check out more of Kevin's work, you can go on Instagram and search Kevin Cly _ tattoos. Cly is spelled C-L-Y. And yeah, show him some love because he is extremely talented. That person's saying stuff again? Yeah, block.
He was being mean.
Block that person. Bye!
Tell me to come up here.
Bam! Whoa. The other people are on
like
board.
Here, come up, whisper to me. What'd they say?
I'll whisper it to you.
Oh.
Oh.
This is not that kind of channel. Yeah.
Why is it back down? We're gonna break the chair.
You can grab another chair. There's like any rolly chair. Anyone. Roll out.
This one's cold.
Because you were sitting on the other one for like 3 hours.
You look like one of my friends. I didn't know you had any tattoos.
Once in a while, I
just
didn't know she was a grill.
A grill?
How long has it been?
It's been 4 hours, about 4.5 hours. It's been quite agonizing, but it's worth it.
You're doing great.
I don't know what that meant.
I don't even know how to say that. Someone's making a request for you to say subscribe to my channel in German, but I don't know how to pronounce any of it.
Embenot Minen
Canal.
Canal.
What if it actually doesn't mean that?
I don't know. I just cursed out someone, I think.
Can I walk and join the stream?
Can you?
Is a trailer for Riverdale a possibility? Yes. Riverdale's the best.
I said before that I will not be making. I will not be making TV show
you
trailers.
You did say that.
With the exception of maybe a handful, just a few that like Nickelodeon shows and American Horror Story. Because most of those are all on DVD. And I grew up with them, so like I know all the episodes pretty well. So it would be a lot easier.
Me
but, like,
too, Lola Rodman.
But a show like Riverdale or Doctor Who, even 13 Reasons Why or Stranger Things, like. With most of them being streaming, it's really hard to rivet to my computer for editing purposes. Plus, there's so much going on. There's a lot of episodes. Same with The Walking Dead and other popular TV shows. I really don't have enough time a day to edit these shows as it is. Like, I only have maybe 5 hours a day, 6 on a good day.
That's after working a whole day too.
Yeah, because if you guys didn't know, I still have a full time job. I was actually down the street that way, where I'm a video producer there and a social media director. So I'm working all the time. I'm editing all the time. So editing literally is everything in my life.
How do you like Markiplier's Who Killed Markiplier videos?
Oh, that was so good. Like
a shorty.
oh my god, like when Mark playing Jim came on screen, he's like, oh, Shuri, I lost my shit. I was laughing so hard. Like I watched it over and over again. I kept laughing harder and harder. And I sent it to John. He's like, you would laugh at something like that.
Someone wants to know if you're in America.
If I'm in America or if I'm an American.
You're in America.
I am in America. I am in Ohio.
States.
Ohio is where it's at.
It's 5 p.m. Someone asked for the time.
Yeah.
I don't know, what are you going to be for Halloween?
I don't know. Next Friday is going to be my work's trunk or treat. I'm thinking about going as Minnie Mouse. Because I have to work that. I'm gonna be recording the whole thing.
Oh, you're recording?
Yeah.
Video? Mm-hmm. Well, you did video last time, didn't you?
I did it the past 2 times.
I don't know. I was there.
Yeah, I get to have another full day of pay.
What's your favorite book and why?
Oh, I knew you'd jump up a nut.
Yeah. I like
the Chronicles of Narnia, The Lion, The Witch, and the Wardrobe, just because.
I feel like every question is relating to this lion that's on your arm. What's your favorite movie? The Lion, the Witch, and the Wardrobe. Or,
What's
Narnia.
What's your favorite band? Narnia.
Yeah, yeah, the soundtrack.
I'm like trying so hard to keep a straight face because this hurts really badly.
You're awesome.
Thank you.
Her phone always has notifications going on, like at all times.
Someone says, can you make some game trailers?
The only game trailer that I would consider doing would be for Super Smash Bros. Brawl. Just because I grew up on that and like I know the story fairly well because there's a lot of cutscenes from that. But for other video games, it's probably going to be a no-go because, for one, there's just so much to work with. And it might be hard to make it like out of context, like a totally different genre. Whereas with Super Smash Bros. Brawl, the Subspace Emissary, that whole storyline, like I can make a pretty awesome action trailer out of that.
How'd you like Mark's tour?
Oh, that Mark's show was amazing. It pretty much just. Whose Line Is It Anyway? But with very good looking people and people who you like really look up to on YouTube. Because Ethan was there, Tyler, Bob Wade, Mark, obviously, It was so good. It was so well put together. And if you guys have not gone yet, or are going to, or are not going to go at all, they never do the same show twice. I mean, there are some similarities here and there, like with some things are scripted, but the majority of things are actually not scripted. Like it's pretty much 80% improv. At the beginning of the show, the audience chooses what genre of play or show that you want. I believe the one that we got was horror, which is really cool. I'm sure there would be like action, fantasy. I'm not sure what the other ones were. He didn't want to spoil it. It was fantastic.
Someone asked me a good question a while ago. I forgot what it was. Do you play an instrument?
I don't. I wish I played guitar or piano, but I'm not talented like that.
Will there be new merch?
Yeah, we're sick of you wearing that shirt.
Like the hat.
I want to make hats soon. I know that Spreadshirt does not make hats, which is kind of a bummer. So I might be.
I don't want to forget that.
I might be switching websites, depending on if another website is free to sell merch. But if it sells hats, I'll go for that one.
Do you know Tomato Biscuit?
Yes, I do.
And you're in a video of hers. You know that?
Yeah, he posted yesterday because I think like 2 weeks ago he posted on Twitter that he just hit 3,000 subscribers and he wanted to make a video collabing with a bunch of smaller YouTubers or YouTubers who were big with hundreds of thousands of subscribers or even millions, just talking about what being a YouTuber means to them. And so I saw that he was asking for videos, and I'm like, I gotta help this guy out. Like he seems very genuine, very intelligent, has very good meaning with his channel because he said in his video yesterday that like a year or two ago, I don't know how long it was, but a YouTuber saved his life. Like he was very depressed, but someone who was a YouTuber, I don't know who it was, but his message just saved his life, and that's what he wants to do as a YouTuber. Like he wants to pay it forward with other pay it forward on YouTube and just really make an impact on people's lives.
Someone said, I already know the answer to this. Someone says your nails are the best. I don't get fake nails because they'll mess up my real nails.
They're actually real. I say in my 50 Facts About Me video, my nails are actually real. I paint them myself. I have my mom's good genes because she has long, strong nails. So yeah, I got acrylics once, never did it again because they just fucked up my nails. It was horrible.
Cool. Someone says, when is your birthday? Can we know when?
Yeah, my birthday is June 3rd. I just turned 23 this year.
Do you regret getting an Apple Watch? I know.
do I regret getting an Apple Watch?
Yeah.
No. No. This, I really like how it counts my... tracks my steps and is able to link up with my calorie counter and like I'm able to see messages right away and able to see the weather right on my wrist, the time obviously.
When we get married, are we gonna live stream? That's what's
gonna I don't know.
We'll have someone on the side like reading questions with a microphone.
I'll do it.
For sure I want our wedding to be on video.
I like it. These are questions up my alley now. Thoughts on thoughts on the iPhone 10?
I don't know all that much about it except like the features of it.
Except that your boyfriend's buying it.
Yeah, John's gonna get it next month.
Next week.
I don't know. I will need to see it in person, and I'll use John's for a little bit just to get a feel for it. But if like cameras always win me over, so if I really like the camera of the 10 over the 8, then I might splurge and get the 10.
You played with the camera on the 8 though.
I did. I do like that. I do like the camera. I really like how the depth effect is a lot much more smooth.
Someone said that they made the witch comic of you on Twitter, and they wanted to know what your biggest regret in life is. Getting deep.
I really like that. That. What?
Random.
Somebody said if your boyfriend gets the iPhone 10, please cancel the wedding.
the witch picture on Twitter. I really like that. That was so cute. Thank you so much for that. My biggest regret in life.
Not meeting me sooner.
And it's pretty wild that she knew you back when you guys were in like elementary school or something.
Yep. It's been a long time.
I actually went through a window.
I don't think I really have any regrets. Because I try to live my life as freely as possible. And if I said that I regretted like what I had posted on Facebook like 5 or 6 years ago, then I would be saying like I regret where I am today. But I mean I really don't regret anything that happened in my past. Like everything happened for a reason. I'm here for a reason. Funny quick story. 4 years ago today, I was volunteering face painting for our local Halloween hayrides. And this is before John and I officially met, but John, Kelly, and was Melissa there?
Melissa. No, wait, Melissa wasn't there.
No, she wasn't
there. Our friend Jess, Dan, I think Kat were all there. They came in and they got their makeup done. I did of my now friend's makeup, but John and I were in the same room together 4 years ago today.
Yeah, like 6 months
so
prior
weird.
To actually talking with her.
Six?
4 months? I don't know, I can't count.
3 months.
3 months. And we went to Melt that same
like,
night.
You had to like backtrack
so cool.
Yeah, I know, right?
Yeah, it's like,
someone it's asked, so weird, that are you ever going to dye like, your hair?
Everyone that went to the Haunted Hayride, Kelly,
I don't know.
Jessica,
I would either go, I would
people.
One extreme
two,
or
the
other.
Same,
I would do
four
like
years, it's
black
so
or platinum blonde or white. But I like my natural hair. I've never dyed it
what?
Before.
Oh!
Who's Sarah?
Sarah, how do you say her last name?
Hi, Sarah.
Hi, Sarah.
Oh, that's really cool. You should have said hi to us at Target. Funny story, some guy saw me at Target and said hi, I didn't know who he was. That might have been here. No, it wasn't.
Someone says what happened, but I don't know what they're talking about.
I don't know what happened. What are you referring to? What happened? So yeah, if you guys are just joining us, I'm getting my 10th tattoo with Kevin Clyde. We are at State Street Tattoo on Menor Avenue in Ohio. And the tattoo I'm getting when he's just about done, it is Aslan the Lion from Narnia. And it is very painful, but it looks amazing. I'm so excited to show, to take pictures for it to be done. And like, because I've been wanting this tattoo since January of this year. Yeah, so for 10 months I've been wanting it. Any more comments?
There was one. Somebody asked, I forget what it said though. What moment made you think, holy crap, I think editing is my thing?
When you bought that shirt.
I know when I was in high school, I took a tech program my junior and senior year, and that had to do with video editing and photography. And I had already been editing like 2 or 3 years before that. I'd always had a thing for movies, like, because I always thought I was going to be a movie director. But when I started making more and more movies, I would edit, I would film, direct, and edit everything. And I'm, and had so many compliments and comments on the editing of just how it was really good. But I still consider myself a director until about until I started at my full-time job as a professional editor, working full-time. It wasn't really my style of editing because it was just really interviews and just kind of like basic videos, kind of vlog types, but mostly interviews. But then when I started my channel last year and making that first video and getting shared the same day by Rhett himself from Rhett Link, that initial moment, I'm like, this is what I want to do. Sorry. I love editing. So I think when I found out that I truly wanted to be a video editor was just last year. Like that was when it hit me. I'm like, I love making movie trailers. This is what I want to do for a living.
Someone said something.
Oh gosh. I like this one. If you were a crayon, what color would you be and what would your signature Crayola name be? Sorry, I know it's random, but I think it's a funny question.
I would probably be a pink color because I know pink is like a very fun, bright, friendly color. The name that I would put it, I would make it as, probably Danny Rose, because that's actually my real middle name is Rose. So I'll be called Danny Rose.
Hi from Austria.
Hi from Austria? Hi from Ohio.
Hello from Sweden.
Hello Sweden, hi from Ohio. Wait, where are you guys from on the stream? Let me know.
Hello from Massachusetts.
Hello, Massachusetts.
Someone else has a Rose as a middle name as well.
Oh, awesome.
Oh, boy.
Okay,
two comes in, we're like freaking it. Virginia?
What advice do you have for a smaller YouTuber that's desperately trying to get their content out there? I'm from Ohio, too, by the way. Love you.
Oh, awesome.
Oh, cool. Meet us at Melt.
my biggest and best advice is to make content that makes you happy first. Because if you're trying to make content just for views, you're really not gonna be happy with the outcome because you're making stuff tailored just to that audience and not to you, not to yourself. So make stuff that makes you happy first. Find a passion if you want to do. Want to make video games, short films, you want to do how-to videos, beauty videos, you want to do vlogs, like make videos that tailor to your heart, personality.
Ohio people here.
How many people are on the stream that are from Ohio?
Yeah, what city are you in Ohio?
We live in the Cleveland area, but right now we're in Menor, Ohio. We're gonna be in Cleveland. Actually, we're gonna be in Cleveland tonight because we are seeing Ray William Johnson live and meeting him tonight.
Ohio. I know, man. It should be a nap.
What's your status edit from the Philippines here?
What's my what? My
saddest edit?
I don't think I've really done a sad edit. I've done a lot of emotional edits. I'd say my edit of Up was probably the one that really got me a lot. The drama one of Inside Out from the seven different genres. That one hit me hard because I made it very personal to me. I can relate to that a lot.
Kevin, someone had a question for you.
Yeah.
They said, what's the most painful part of your body to get a tattoo on?
I always try to give the best answer by saying what I've experienced tattooing people. I would say your rib area is top three. Maybe your throat. Sternum, foot. Yeah, definitely. Definitely those areas for sure. My sternum was my most painful.
Someone wants to know, Danny, did you or do you do any sports?
I did not play any sports in school. I obviously played them in the gym. I've always liked basketball. I always thought I was fairly okay at basketball. But I also really like badminton. But yeah, I don't really play any sports. If I were to play a sport, it would be probably badminton.
Badminton's fun.
I love badminton.
You ever play Mr. Rigo? Badminton?
Yeah. Mr. Rigo's insane at badminton.
Dude, he fucking crushes. He has like this little just darting all over the place.
I know the name, I can't put a face.
Oh, teacher too.
Was he short?
Short, yeah.
Okay,
short.
Yes, yeah, now I know.
Carlton, we call him Carlton.
Yeah. I did not play him in bed. But I remember when we were playing basketball, I was shooting singles, and he came up to me, he's like, why aren't you on the girls' basketball team? You're really good. I'm like, oh, I don't have time to for sports.
Showing up shortly.
Oh, cool.
Yeah, he'll join us for lunch. Dinner?
Awesome.
Dinner. The questions are slowing down.
How many people are watching?
24.
Okay. It's going on 5:30. We have to be at Cleveland Improv at 6:45. And it takes 30 minutes to get there.
So what are we going to do?
Something small, I don't know.
What? I always over exaggerate the times. Who are we seeing tonight?
Ray William Johnson.
You don't even know?
I think I saw his picture once.
You should
see how he spelled his name in his search, though. Not even close.
Someone said he's still a thing.
He's going on a comedy tour.
I see 7:30 p.m. That sounds more like 7:30 to 9:30.
But the ticket says recommended arrival time 6:45.
I guess, but I mean, as long as you get there at 7:30,
yeah,
you'll be fine.
And if you want to melt, you sit at the bar, you get served a lot quicker.
Okay.
It's also a Thursday night. I doubt it's going to be too busy.
That's true.
Yeah.
Downtown over here.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Maybe we can go to like Chick-fil-A or something.
No, we're fine. We're going to melt. I've been thinking about melt for way too long.
I know. We've tried it all day and thought about melt.
Let's sit at the bar so that we can get
someone
served
says,
quickly.
Can you wish me luck on my test tomorrow?
I wish you luck on your test. Good luck.
I mean, as long as we get out, we go by 7, we're fine. At the latest, and we won't take it that long.
Oh, I'm so tired.
But the rule is you can't take naps. My rule is you can't take naps after 5 o'clock.
That hasn't stopped you!
What kind of rule is that? I'll take a nap at 9:30, I don't care.
9:30? No, that's sleep time. It's sleep time.
I work night shift.
Yeah.
Danny, can you touch your nose with your tongue? Salutes from Argentina.
No.
Freed me, I'm dying.
What? You're dying. I cannot touch my tongue to my nose.
We're done.
Woo! Hey, bonito. What?
Yeah, you're good.
I'll show everybody.
Oh, this is the final product. Oh, my arm's dead. What do you guys think?
so realistic.
I'm gonna check up in the mirror.
You know how many times I'm gonna like forget she has a new tattoo that I gotta touch it?
Yeah, tonight at the comedy show, I'm like, ah!
You're right, I always have to like touch. I'm a toucher when I.
Oh. Now she's staring at us. How's it going, everybody?
You guys take the spotlight for a little bit.
Oh.
Oh, I'm not ready.
Not here to see us.
No, no one wants to see us. So.
Oh, hi guys. How's it going?
Hi.
Hello. Yeah, that's the clock. It's melting.
Okay, I'm gonna take this.
Bye.
Bye, guys.
Danny's taking
you. Oh, there's my hand. Okay, so the tattoo is all done, and we're gonna show his coworker the finished tattoo. This is Phil. Say hi, Phil.
Steve, I mean.
Yeah. Sorry.
I'm not Phil.
Well, you said Phil. This is Steve, actually. Say hi, Steve.
Oh, nice selection, man. Thank you.
Oh, this is going to be a fun recovery. Okay, so I think I'm going to end the live stream here because I want to get some pictures of this. And then we're going to go eat. And then we're going to go see Ray William Johnson.
And get Melt.
Yeah, we're going to get Melt. Say hi, everybody.
Bye.
Bye. Bye.
See you later. I'm like a double wave of.